In this lesson, we will see together les pronoms et déterminants indéfinis. But more precisely, we will see chacun and chacune. So the main question is, what are les pronoms et déterminants indéfinis? We use the indefinite pronouns and determiners when we don't want to be too precise. And this is the key thing. Huh? These determinants, pronoms indéfinis are used when we don't want to be too precise. And we would rather give a more general word to speak about a person, a place, or a thing. So it will be possible to use them for a person, a place, or a thing. So, this lesson is about chacun and chacune. And they mean each one, everyone. So, it is used to emphasize the individuality. And it is used as a pronoun. So we'll see some examples. Regarde ces pâtisseries. Chacune semble délicieuse. Regarde ces pâtisseries. Chacune semble délicieuse. So in that situation, it's quite interesting because as you can see, we want to replace pâtisserie. Pâtisserie is a feminine plural noun. So we go back to the singular form and we will keep the feminine form and we will use the feminine pronoun chacune. Regarde ces pâtisseries, chacune semble délicieuse. Chacun de ces tiroirs a été difficile à installer. Chacun de ces tiroirs a été difficile à installer. So in that situation, chacun is connected to tiroir. Tiroir is a masculine word, so we will go for the masculine singular, chacun. Let's have two more examples. Tu as trouvé une place libre parce qu'ici, chacune est prise. Tu as trouvé une place libre parce qu'ici, chacune est prise. So here, chacune is connected to place and it's feminine. Tu as demandé aux clients de régler leur facture. Est-ce que chacun à payer? Tu as demandé aux clients de régler leur facture. Est-ce que chacun a payé? So in that situation, chacun is connected to client, masculine word, and we go for the masculine singular here, chacun.